How long does it take to fully charge an iPhone X on a wireless Qi charger and a wired connection? Well, that's kind of what this quick video is about. I'm going to be charging two brand new iPhone X's from 0 to 100% and see how long it's going to take using both methods. The wireless Qi charger I'm using is from Rav Power, and this is claimed to have fast wireless charging for the iPhone X and both the iPhone 8 models. However, the current iOS does not have fast wireless charging enabled just yet, but once Apple releases it in a later update, you can take advantage of the fast wireless charging feature. So the Rav Power Qi charger has a maximum output of 7.5 watts, which is actually 50% faster than traditional 3.5 watt Qi chargers. And just for comparison reasons, the stock Apple Power Brick actually has an output of 5 watts. The charger itself is very sleek, with anti-rubber coating that won't scratch the back of your new iPhone, and it also prevents phones from slipping off. Furthermore, you can always protect your phone with some skins. I currently have the black carbon fiber wrapped behind my iPhone 7 Plus while I wait for the new iPhone X skins to arrive. It's a minimalistic approach to not only protecting your phone from getting scratches, but also adding some grip in the process. I'll drop a link to some dbrand skins down below and the Qi charger if you guys want to check it out. So as I said before, these are both fresh iPhone X's that I just unboxed, and I purposely drained the batteries so that they shut off completely. I'm going to plug one of the phones into the wall using the Apple Power Brick and Lightning cable, and I'm going to be placing the other one on the Rav Power Qi wireless charger and start the timer. Both phones have the exact same settings out of the box, they are connected to the same network, and they don't have any extra apps installed or have anything running in the background. We can see at the 30 minute mark that the iPhone X that's plugged directly in the wall is already at 22%, while the wireless charging iPhone is at 17%. Fast forwarding to the 1 hour mark, we can see that the numbers pretty much doubled. The wired is at 42% and the wireless is at 30%. And finally, a full charge on the iPhone X using the stock Apple Lightning cable and power brick will take you 2 hours and 58 minutes, starting from 0%. While the wireless charging phone is still at 79%, almost after 3 hours later. It would take you around 4 hours and 20 minutes to fully charge your iPhone X wirelessly without the fast wireless charging option. Keep in mind guys, the new Apple fast wireless charging feature is not yet available on the brand new iPhones. That's actually coming in a later update. So make sure you guys are subscribed because I'm going to be redoing this entire test with the new update. That pretty much wraps up this video. If this was somewhat helpful to you guys, dropping a like would be awesome. But if you guys didn't like it, feel free to dislike as well. That's cool too. It did take me an entire day to shoot this video, believe it or not. And if this is the type of videos that you guys love watching, make sure to let me know in the comment section because I think I'm going to start doing more of these as time moves on. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll drop a link to the dbrand skin I use as well as the Qi charger below if you guys want to check it out. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.